In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can organize our photos and videos in the Photos app. We're going to look at how we can do this with personal albums, or what I call personal albums. These are not shared albums. I have another video on how we create shared albums. But basically what we're able to do is we're able to create an album and then we place our photos and videos into that album. And we can do this from the Photos library. We can do this from our collections. We can also create folders for our albums, so then we can group them together. And we can even change the view of the albums when we're looking at it in the Photos app. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can organize our photos and videos into albums with the Photos app on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the way that we organize our photos and videos on the iPhone is through the Photos app. So let's go ahead and open it up. From here, what we need to do is we need to go to our collections. Now, if you're not familiar with the layout of the Photos app, this was recorded with iOS 18. Apple dramatically changed the interface with iOS 18. So if you're using an earlier version of iOS, such as iOS 17, you probably won't be able to follow along. It's not going to work for you. So this video is really created for people using iOS 18 or later. So what were the differences? Well, let's just take a quick look. If we look here, you're going to see I have my photo library up at the top. This is where I can view all of my photos and videos. And then below that, what we have are our different collections. Collections being photos and videos, collection of photos and videos based on specific criteria. This could be screenshots. It could be my favorite photos and videos. And in this case here, when I swipe up, it can also be albums, my personal albums. So basically, when we create an album here, we're only going to see them on our own devices, as long as we're using iCloud. So when I create an album here, I'm going to be able to see this album in the Photos app on my Mac and my iPad. But no one else is going to see them. So how do we create these albums? What are the different options that we have? Well, the first thing that we do is we just tap on albums here. I want to look at all of my different albums. Tap on it. And then from here, what we do is we just go up to create. When I tap on create, we're going to have a couple of options. And the one that we're going to focus on right now is new album. We want to create a new album. I recently went to Disney. So I want to create an album with those photos and videos. I tap on it. And now I just go and name it. So let's just call this Disney 2025. So just type in here, Disney, and 2025. From here, I just tap on Add Photos, and I can go and select the photos that I want to add to that. So I just tap on it, and now I can select the photos that I want to add. So I just swipe up, and I can view all of my photos in my library. Now, what I did previous to this is I went through and favorited my photos and videos, the ones that I want to add. If you want to see how I did that, take a look at my video on how we view our photos and videos within the Photos app. Basically, when you're viewing a photo or a video, if you like it, what you're able to do is add a heart to it. It favorites it. And if we look here, you're going to see that I have a heart there. That one is favorited. Makes it really easy to select the favorite photos and videos to add to your album. We know how easy it is to take 100 photos. We don't want to show 100 photos, so we can go and favorite them. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select a few of these that have these hearts here. Makes it really easy to select my favorite photos and videos. So I'm just going to select a few of these here. If I wanted to view what was selected, I can show my selected, get a closer look at them. I can also search. Maybe I'm not finding the photo that I want. I can search my library and add it that way. And then if I want to add a photo or video from a collection, again, take a look at that other video on how we can view our photos and videos with collections. What I'm able to do is take photos or videos from a specific collection and add them to this album. In this case here, we're just going to keep it simple. I'm just going to keep it at photos and I select the ones that I want. Now, all I do is just tap on add. And when I do, it added those photos and videos. Now, to create the album, I just tap on create. And I've just created that album. So when we go over here to this album and tap on it, I can see all the photos and videos that I added. Now, this is just a collection. Again, take a look at that other video on collections, or actually how we view our photos and videos. With a collection, this is actually split into two. So we have a little video, a montage of our photos and videos that the Photos app creates. I can view that. Or if we look below that, you're going to see that I have all the individual photos and videos of that album. So now what I'm able to do is swipe up and I can view all the photos and videos in there. I want to add more. I tap on the plus. I can go and add more. I'm going to cancel this. And if I want to view a video of this, I just go down to the bottom here and you're going to see it says photos. I tap on movie and watch what happens. I can see a movie of those photos and videos within that album. I want to go back to my photos. I just tap on it. And then you tap on photos, and it brings you back to the photos. We have a few options when we're looking at the video. It's kind of cool. I'm going to go back over to my movie here. And what I'm able to do is change the music. I can add filters. I tap on that. And now I tap on this to change the music. Or I'm going to tap on done. We're just going to leave it. Or what I can do is I can apply filters. I tap on the filter here, and now I can select which filter I want to add. You can also, I'm going to tap on done here. We can also just swipe to the left or right to add filters. So if you want to apply a filter, you just swipe to the left or right. When you are done, all you have to do is just tap on the photo or video, and it brings you back. We can get a preview of that movie. And then if we want to look at all of our photos and videos within that album again, we just tap on it, and then we go over here to photos. Tap on it, and there it is. So that is the basics of how we create an album. You want to add more photos again, you tap on the plus. You want to delete a photo, you long press on it, and then what you're able to do is remove it from that album. It doesn't delete it from your Photos app, it just removes it from the album. We do have a few more options with this when we're looking at our movie. So I'm going to go to the movie here. Let's say you wanted to save this movie. So you tap on movie, and then when you tap on it again, you're going to see the three dots in the upper right hand corner. From here, what I'm able to do is share this movie. I can also edit the timeline, view all the photos and videos within that. And then if I want to loop the movie so it plays over and over again, I can do that as well. And then favorite it. We can save this as a memory. What is a memory? A memory is basically just another collection. So I'm going to tap on add to favorite memories. And now when we go back to my Photos app, I'm going to get out of my albums here. We have a collection called memories, and we can see that I just added that Disney to that. So now all I have to do is just tap on that and I can show that album. So that's basically all we have to do to create an album. We just go over to our albums here, tap on it, and then we create our album. From there we can go and modify, we can remove photos, we can add more photos. Now when we're looking at all of our photos and videos here, what we can do is we can change the view of this. Right now, this is in a list view. Well, when we go over to our three dots here, what we're able to do is change this into a key photo view. It's kind of a neat little look, so I'm going to tap on it. And now we can see we have a key photo here, and then we have some of the other photos from that album. So now what I'm able to do is just kind of scroll up and get a better idea of what these different albums are. In addition to that, we can also put them into folders. If we look here, I'm going to swipe up here a little bit, you're going to see that it looks like I have different albums there. That is a folder, and we can actually see it in the lower left-hand corner. It's a folder. So these are all of the photos or all the albums that I use when I demonstrate how to edit. So I can see all my photos where I can lift a subject. I can see all of my edits for a lesson. So these are all just different types of albums, and they're within a folder. When we look at it in our list view, I go back up to the three dots. Remember, we can change our view. We go over here to list. I can also see my folders here. So how do we create a folder and add albums to that folder? Well, remember when we went up here to create an album? We have an option to create a new folder. So now I tap on that, and let's just call this one trips. I want to have a folder of all my different trips. So I type in here trips, and then I just go to add albums. And from here, I just go and select the albums I want to add. So I'm going to go with these three here. I tap on them. We can see we have a blue check mark, which means that they're selected. And now I just tap on add, and I've added those to that album or to that folder. So I tap on create. And if we look, you're going to see I have trips here. And when I open that up, I can see all of those albums within that folder. To remove a folder from an album, we just long press on it. Let's say I wanted to remove this. I long press on it, and then you're going to see remove from folder. Tap on it, and it removes it. I have to confirm it, but now you're going to see I have two. I go back to all of my albums, and there's the Disney. I want to add it back in. How can we do that? Drag and drop. So I just drag Disney on top of that folder. So let's just go ahead and do that. Long press on it, and I can drag it around. And then when I put it on trips, you're going to see that it changes colors. That means it's going to go into that folder. So I select it. And now when I go back in here, we can see that album is in that folder again. We have another option when we're working with our folders. We can also filter them. So let's say you have a lot of albums. And what you would like to do is put them into different folders so you have it all nicely arranged. But you have a long list here. You want to just see your folders. We go up to the three dots here, and what we're able to do is filter by folder. So I tap on it, and I can select folders. So when I tap on that, now I'm just looking at my folders. So I can easily hide all those different albums. Now when we actually go into a folder, so let's just go into trips here. Being that the filter is on, I can't see any of the albums. Remember, I'm filtering by folders. But Apple makes it really easy to turn that filter off. All we do is just remove the filter here. And now I can see all the albums in there. Now, being that that filter is off, when we go back over here, you're going to see that I can see all of my albums again. So it turns it off globally for the Photos app. Now, I've mentioned collections a little bit. When we go back over here to all of my collections, you're going to see that I have all these different collections. And one of them here is pinned collections. It's one of my favorite collections. What we're able to do is pin our favorite collections, such as screenshots or favorites. In addition to that, what we're also able to do is pin albums to this collection. So when I tap on pinned collections here, what I'm able to do is view all of my favorite albums here. So how do we add a personal album to this pinned collection? Well, what we need to do is we need to go back to the album. So I'm going to tap on the caret here. And then we go to my albums. We select the album. So I'm going to go to trips. I want to add Disney here. I long press on it. And when I long press on it, it gives me the option to pin it. When I pin this, it's going to pin it as a collection. So let's just go ahead and do that. It's now pinned as a collection. What does that mean? Well, let's go back over to all of my collections here. And what you're going to see under pinned collections is my Disney. If I want to modify this, move it around, I can do that. I tap on modify. This is the beauty of the Photos app with iOS 18, is how we can customize this for our own use. All I need to do is just drag this up. And now that is going to be pinned at the beginning. I tap on the X. And when we look at my collections here, we can see that that is shown there. So if you're showing an album a lot, what you can do is you can easily pin it to your collections. If you don't see this pinned collection, I should have clarified this in the beginning, but if you don't see this pinned collections here, what you need to do is you need to go down to the bottom, and then you're going to see customize and reorder. And then from there, you need to make sure that pinned collections has a blue check mark. And if you want it at the top, what you need to do is you just need to make sure that you drag it up towards the top where mine is. Then when you do that, what you're able to do is easily find all of your pinned collections just by going to this area here. Now we can also create an album from the photo library. So if you're familiar with the Photos app, basically they split it in two with iOS 18. Photo library, collections. We've seen how we can do it through the collection. That's about the easiest way to do it. But we can also create an album and add photos to an album through the photo library. So we need to go into the photo library. How do we do that? Swipe down. When we swipe down, we're going to get to a point where we see this little tab bar. This tells me that I'm in my photo library. Again, take a look at my other video on how we can view our photos and videos in the Photos album. I talk a little bit more about this photo library. So I'm looking at my photo library, and what I would like to do is I would like to add this photo here to that album. Or what I'd like to do is add this video here. How can we do that? Well, basically, we just long press on it. When I long press on it, you're going to see the option to add it to an album. I tap on that, and then I select the album. Now this is in a folder, so I need to tap on the folder, and then I just tap on Disney. Select it, and it added it to that album. Let's go and add a couple more. To do that, we tap on Select. I can add more than one at a time. So I tap on Select. I select the photos and videos, so we're just going to go, I'm going to swipe down here a little bit. We're going to go with a few of these. Let's just go with these here. I tap on them. You're going to see that we have the blue check mark. They are selected. Let's go with one more. We're going to go with that one there. And now what I do is I go to the three dots down here. And when I do that, you're going to see the option to add it to the album. And then I go through the same process. I select the folder, and then I go and select that album. But being that I just added some photos and videos to that album, to that Disney 2025, look what we have here. Add to Disney 2025. It keeps the most recent album that you've added photos and videos to. So now I can just tap on that, and it just added those to that album. If you want to create an album, you can do that as well. I'm going to long press on this one. And when I do that, I go to Add Album. And if I don't want to add it to any of these, what I do is I just tap on the plus up here, and I can go and create a new album. Just follow the steps just like we did before. So we can add photos and videos from our photo library, or what we can do is we can actually go into, to exit the photo library, tap on the X. What we can do is we go to our collections, we go into the album, and then we can add them from there as well. So I tap on it, and then from here, I long press on this. When I long press on it, I get a contextual menu, and then from here, I'm able to add photos. So that's basically how we work with our different personal albums. So that's how we can organize our photos and videos in the Photos app on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. You're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you do become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.